the breath of eternal life, with this cross of life, I open your mouth to the breath of eternity. May you live forever, O King. Is Ramses II, the great conquering king of the Middle Kingdom. He lived approximately 3,200 years ago. I am sorry to say that one of the really stupid things about this palace museum is these open archways here. They have on all four sides of this square, so that if you're going along through the galleries over there, as I am over on this side, wham, you can't go any further. You either have to go upstairs and across and hope that it isn't shut off, or down underground and across. Now that's what is happening right here. See, there's the fourth side over there, where you can't get there from here. That's the door over there, where you can't go through, because there's a passageway outdoors. Oh look, you can even see the light coming in under the door. There's a passageway right through the building, and we are not allowed to go out there. What we have to do is go down the stairs, or take the elevator, which, as it happens, is right here. Egyptians were very big on preparing for death. They made their many sarcophagi from wood and from stone, as well as from precious metals. The effect of this all is to give you the feeling that it is not so very surprising that Moses was an Egyptian, or that he revolutionized religion, leading to the long process and development of Judaism and Christianity and Islam. Death is only a passageway into eternal life. And yet, it is important to be prepared for it. And the more money and power you have, the more you will spend on your coffin, the more you will spend on your tombstone, the more you will spend on your death. In fact, an entire book was written of how to prepare for death, how to embalm the body, what prayers to recite, crossing the river of night, what rituals to perform so that everything goes right. All of these sacred actions recorded here in the Egyptian Book of the Dead. How to put your chitlins in the jars. How to open your mouth with the sacred cross. How to preserve everything for the afterlife. How to give yourself an army of servants in the form of little statues, rather than cutting off the heads of all your household. Some more art, but it happens to be contemporary video art. Over there on that screen, an upside down view underneath the great glass pyramid in the lobby of the Louvre.